right, so today's project is
working on the backyard. Some piles of dirt back here, lots of weeds. I'm gonna get some grass seed planted, additional dirt on this side. We got piles of brick that's gotta go. These are two old apple trees that aren't really giving nice apples, so we're gonna get rid of those, and then we wanna put some new fruit trees in this section right here beside the driveway. Let's take a look over here what this is gonna entail. Just kind of a mess. So we wanna kinda clean this all up, get rid of some junk, some nice grass planted here. First thing we're going to do is move the bricks so we can cut the trees hopefully tomorrow.
All right, ready?
Good morning, it's Saturday morning, and the plan today is to take down the two trees. So
this is the first tree. Relatively easy, but as you can see, the bottom is really kind of sketchy here. So, oh, look, there's nails in here too. Lovely. See the stump here? I left a fairly thick hinge, about 2 inches, just because I wanted to be sure that it's gonna not suddenly swing sideways.
Started with a little still, so nice just for limbing, nice and small.
Oh.
right, we're done taking down those trees and getting the stumps below ground. We're just gonna do a last little bit of cleanup here. And then we're done for the day. What?
I just want to get it kind of leveled out. I'm not going to seed because it's going to be dry for the next week or so. This is where we're at. This has all been leveled out. I'm gonna wait till we're gonna get some rain in the forecast before I think of seeding it. Well, we split a bunch of the wood and we moved the rest just on the gravel section so we can work on this section here. So we got... What I'm working on today is we got an ancient fence back here that's kind of falling apart. But we're gonna take the fence out, so then once I'm done working here, we'll build a bit of a berm and then rebuild the fence. So let's get the backhoe here working and let's see if we can pull this fence out. Well, this is going quicker and easier than I expected.
There's our whole back fence.
All right, we've taken down the fence, so today we're gonna start doing some serious heavier landscaping with the tractor. It's gonna be a hot one, I don't know. We'll see how long we can bear the heat.
All right, so we have a bit of a problem with the gas tank. Every time I would lean back, like going up a hill, gas would come running out. And it's basically where the fuel gauge goes into the tank. So we're gonna take that out and put some sealant around there. I had an old cork seal that's falling apart. I'm supposed to let this air dry till it becomes tacky. That's fixed. Let's see if it stays dry. So we started building the berm. We used mostly just dirt that had a lot of gravel and stones in it. And that's the first layer there. And now this is all more topsoil to our right. And I'm going to be spreading that over there and then trying to level this all out. Old the MF-40s and I think the MF-30s as well. If you shift gears, it's usually when I'm rushing, if you pull up at all, they get stuck. It's stuck in gear now. So what I need to do is take off the inlet. I just kind of go in there and start clunking around. You see, this is stiff. I can't shift it up or down. Clutch in. This doesn't matter if this isn't forward or reverse. But something, the gear in here has to slide forward. There we go, that's it. Now I can shift. So we're done leveling out roughly for now. You see right beside the garage, it goes down about a foot and I gotta dig it out a bit wider so I can possibly park either the backhoe or a tractor there. I'm gonna build a little lean-to against the garage. So let's get digging that out. Now
that we are level over here, we got some pallets down where we can have the bricks permanently put.
Oh, perfect, right there.
Okay, so we're pretty much done all the hard landscaping. We just need a little bit of gravel. We're right here. This is where we're going to park the camper. The piles all have been leveled out. We have a nice berm along the back, putting in a fence right along the back. I'm not planting any grass seed in the near future just because it's very dry and I want to make sure there's enough rain. Working it up with a skid steer, you see how dusty the dirt gets. Look at this. It's like 2 inches of powder, so we need some rain just to tamp everything down, then I can rake it out and put seed in. All right, we got it leveled out. Now we just got to rake it to get the stones and any sticks or roots out, and then we can seed.
Amounts of area or land to rake, and then you need to level out. Get one of these 36 inch landscape rakes, aluminum, nice and light, and it works a lot quicker. It's a lot easier to get it nice and level. Okay, so one of the last jobs in leveling out all this dirt, you can see the dirt's been all pushed and smoothed out. We got a hill at the back, we got our fence in, is planting grass seeds. So it's been at least a solid month since we leveled this out. You can see there's a lot of weeds. So we're just taking the backhoe and see if we can kind of just scrape the weeds off, not move around too much dirt. So let's fire up the old Massey. Now the problem with the backhoe, it's running on, I think, 2 out of 3 cylinders. Just gonna try to quickly get it done. Right, here's the grass growing. See, it's growing pretty good. And we'll just do one more seeding in the spring, but for now, this is a good start. You can see the straw did pretty much a good job of keeping the grass seed up on this little slope here and not washing away. Hope this video was useful and fairly entertaining, and hope you enjoyed it. Take care, have a great day. See you on the next one.